Matt, we have this new polling out this week. We just ticked through some of the numbers. No surprise at the top of the ticket and also with the Garvey Schiff race. But in terms of the issues, what voters are caring about this election cycle, it brings to mind that famous James Carville quote, "It's the economy, stupid."
That's right. And we've seen that across the country, majorities saying that the economy is their top issue. Here in California, though, it's actually 31% who say that it is their top issue, followed by housing affordability at 19%. Now, these are pretty interesting numbers. If you look even at neighboring states like Arizona, immigration is their top issue, followed by the economy. You look at Nevada, it's sort of a similar picture, the economy followed by immigration, et cetera. So the fact that immigration doesn't even make it into the top three in California, I find that really interesting. And it really speaks to that housing affordability issue that it's so high up the list. A majority say that either the economy or housing is their top issue.
Yeah, indeed. That's something that we hear, especially from these congressional candidates and these battleground races that could potentially decide the balance of power in the House. In terms, though, I just want to talk about the presidential, since Kamala Harris does hail from this state. Anything stick out to you in those numbers? Obviously, we know the voter math here, but just wanted to get your take on that.
Yeah, we find Harris at 59, Trump at 35. No big surprises there that she is ahead by a considerable margin. She's winning independents handsomely. There's not really any sub-demographic that breaks for Trump. This is the same 24-point margin as September when we pulled it then. But what is kind of interesting is that if these results hold on election day, that would represent a 6-point movement towards former President Trump compared to the 2020 results. We've seen this elsewhere in the country where Harris is running a little bit behind Biden, and we're seeing that in California, too.
Yeah, and that's something interesting, too, that the California Republican Party has really been touting out here. They've been seeing a small uptick in voter registration. In terms of what you're seeing, I know you're doing this polling in other states across the country. I know you mentioned some of the neighboring states to us here in California. Are there any comparisons to what we're seeing here in California in other states across the country, especially the battlegrounds that are going to decide this election?
Well, I'm not sure about comparisons. I think really California is unique in its Democrat majority. There are a few other states like that, say New York. We are seeing in places like New York, these really blue states where Republicans are coming up a little bit. We talked about the top of the ballot. We're not necessarily seeing that further down the ballot. In some cases we are, it's hit or miss. But in California, honestly, not too much of a surprise, and it's really mirroring that I don't want to say narrowing, but becoming less of a void between Democrats and Republicans at the statewide level.
Yeah, and I thought the interesting questions that you asked in this poll, too, specific to, those kitchen table issues that we really talk about deciding elections and the economy being top of mind here in California. And two of them are, did folks have to decide between groceries and utilities? And also, did they ever consider leaving the state?
Yeah, and that last one was really interesting. I think it speaks to that housing affordability issue in the state. And we found that a majority, 56%, have considered leaving the state of California due to costs. Majorities of those under 60 say that they have considered leaving. This was highest among the 30 to 39 demographic, about 70%. Found that interesting. I think that that's sort of the natural time when, folks are maybe starting new jobs, getting out of school, et cetera. And that's sort of the hardest time for them. The only group that said they haven't considered leaving by any considerable margin were those who hold a postgraduate degree, not just college degree, but postgrad. And that was at 63%. When we look at some of those trade-offs, we asked whether you had to decide between paying for food or paying the utilities. We found that it's mostly minorities who say, a minority says that they had to make that trade-off. And we found in almost all cases, apart from prescription drugs, It was young people, those who are under the age of 40, who said that they had to make those trade-offs.
Interesting data indeed. All right, Matt Taglia, Senior Director for Emerson College Polling. We appreciate you giving us some time here on Inside California Politics.
Thanks for having me.